Indian Railways is the largest rail network in Asia and world's second largest under one management. It comprises about more than 1 lakh track kilometers and runs about 12,355 trains every day, carrying about 22.53 million passengers per day. Indian Railway has now entered into an exclusive club of countries carrying more than 1 billion tons of freight loading in a year. The first train on the Indian subcontinent ran over a stretch of 21 miles from Bombay to Thane on 16th April 1853, when 14 railway carriages carrying about 400 guests left Bori Bandar at 3:30 p.m. amidst the loud applause of a vast multitude and to the salute of 21 guns. The first passenger train steamed out of Howrah station, destined for Hooghly, to cover a distance of 24 miles on 15th August 1854. Thus, the first section of East Indian Railway was opened to public traffic, initiating the beginning of railway transport on the eastern side of the subcontinent. This was a small beginning which in due course developed into a network of railway lines all over the country. The year 1890 was a witness to a major technological breakthrough, the advent of electric traction in railways. No doubt, it was a modest beginning. Even the operation voltage was only 600 volt DC. Since then, railway electrification has taken great strides. The operation voltage was upgraded to 1200 volt DC to 1500 volt DC to 15 kV AC and 25 kV AC. In India, the first electric train was put in suburban operation when on 3rd February 1925, the first electric train was flagged off from Bombay Viti on its maiden journey to Kurla. The electrification of 1500 volt DC was extended to the suburban services around Madras also by 1931. For mainline operation, electric traction was first considered as a strategy to increase the throughput in the critical grade sections on the then Great Indian Peninsula. Railway between Karjat and Pune on the southeast and Kasara and Igatpuri on the northeast routes from Bombay to the rest of the country. The global depression in the 30s and the Second World War put a brake to further projects of electrification in India. After independence, the suburban services around Calcutta were the first to be considered for electrification when the Calcutta Electrification Project was established in 1954. 3000 volts DC was selected for the electrification of Howrah, Bandel, Bardhaman and Shivrapuli Tarkeshwar sections on the Eastern Railway. 25 kV, 50 cycles per second AC was introduced in France in Isles-Barnes-la-Roche section, which was energized during 1945 to 1952. By 1954, when it was still in its infancy, its full potential was demonstrated to and accepted by the world. UK, Russia, India and Japan were some of the major countries which adopted 25 kV traction for railways. Before it was further extended, a major investment decision was taken to go in for single phase 25 kV AC electric traction on commercial frequency of 50 Hz on some of the important sectors on Indian Railway, keeping in line with the latest technology available at that time and convert Howrah-Bardhaman also to 25 kV AC traction. Mainline electrification was also mooted at this time for the Howrah-Mughalsarai section on the Howrah-Delhi route. Railway electrification provides eco-friendly and pollution-free train operation, faster and heavier haulage capacities because of high horsepower, unlimited current draw from catenary and high-speed potential of electric locomotive, safer, speedier train operation because of color light signaling and optic fiber cable for telecommunication, which give unlimited capacity for communication channels. These works are also undertaken along with electrification. This electric traction also reduces nation's dependence on imported diesel oil. thereby saving on foreign exchange as it is capable of using indigenously available alternative sources of primary energies like coal of any grade, hydel power, surplus petroleum gas, nuclear power, etc. In the wake of industrial development in the eastern region due to the setting up of steel plants, large-scale movement of iron and coal, substantial growth in freight traffic which could not be managed by steam traction, electrification and dieselization had to be introduced in early 60s to cope up with the growing traffic. The pace of electrification, however, slowed down until the oil crisis of 70s. The second oil crisis in particular brought to the fore the need for evolving a long-term policy for electrification to reduce the dependence of railways on petroleum-based energy. In the context of shift from petroleum-based energy in transport sector, it was decided in July 1980 that the railways should speed up electrification at a pace of 1,000 route kilometers per year. Accordingly, the pace of electrification was considerably speeded up and Indian Railways achieved good progress. As against patchy electrification in the past, complete routes were being considered for electrification so that operationally the utilization is optimal. Six major trunk routes of Golden Quadrilateral and diagonals, which are Delhi-Havrah, Delhi-Mumbai via Central and Western Railways, Mumbai-Calcutta, Delhi-Chennai and Havrah-Chennai have already been fully electrified. Electrification of remaining Mumbai-Chennai route
via
Guntakal and Pune is in progress. So far, 23,541 RKM has been electrified on Indian Railway as on 31st March 2013, which is 36.6% of total RKM in Indian Railway, mostly on heavy density routes. To enable the electrical works to be completed according to certain laid down schedule, organizational structure both in the railways as well as private and public sector agencies executing the work in various sections had to be created. During the last 5 decades, sufficient expertise has been generated and the infrastructure available in the country can undertake conventional 25 kV AC traction up to 1200 to 1600 RKM per year. Railway electrification initially started in India under the Eastern Railway in Calcutta, which was later shifted to Lucknow under RDSO, subsequently set up its headquarters at Nagpur and finally at Allahabad and named as Central Organization for Railway Electrification or CORE. CORE is headed by a general manager and assisted by electrical, S&T, civil, stores, personnel, vigilance and finance departments. Presently, 10 RE projects are functioning vis-a-vis Ambala, Bhubaneswar, Chennai, Jaipur, Lucknow, Secunderabad, New Jalpaiguri, Gorakhpur, Danapur and Jabalpur headed by chief project managers assisted by the departments. Apart from these project offices, various RE units were formed to cater to the need of electrification from time to time. These units were headquartered at Mathura, Kota, Bhopal, Vadodara, Nagpur, Vijayawada, Vishakhapattanam, Ranchi, Hajipur and Surat. Let's join our general manager, Shri Jagdev Kalia, and share his words on CORE.
So there is a lot of curiosity in general public about railway electrification. I'll just like to know what exactly is the railway electrification and what is the role of CORE in railway electrification.
In broader sense, railway electrification can mean the use of electricity on railways. But in common parlance, railway electrification means providing infrastructure for introduction of electric traction on railways. The full form of CORE is Central Organization for Railway Electrification. Our role is to provide infrastructure for introduction of electric traction as mentioned earlier. In addition to CORE, RVNL is also carrying out electrification works mostly over the sections where the work of doubling of track also is involved.
So what exactly is meant by infrastructure required for railway electrification?
The most important thing is to lay wires for transmitting the electric energy along the tracks on a special uncommon standard voltage of 25 kilovolts. We call this overhead equipments or the OHE. The next step is to ensure supply of electric energy to the OHE through traction substations, which take power supply on 220 or 132 or 110 kV from power utilities and step down to 25 kilovolts with a host of protection systems. Then the existing signaling and the lighting systems on railway stations is required to be made suitable for 25 kV by providing protection and shielding, etc. Then the existing footer bridges and the other structures have to be ensured safe clearances. Wherever necessary, modifications have to be carried out. Then the supervisory remote control for remote sensing of important parameters and controlling the equipments remotely is provided. And lastly, infrastructure for maintenance facilities is created, which include depots, offices, staff quarters, tar wagon sheds, etc.
What are the benefits of railway electrification?
The first and foremost obvious advantage of railway electrification is that it saves a lot of money to railways. This is because it reduces our dependence on petroleum, and thus it protects us from the vagaries of price fluctuations in petroleum and reduces our import bill. Correspondingly, it reduces railways' operating costs for haulage of goods and passenger traffic to a very great extent. Electric traction also gives better adhesion to wheels, and thus it facilitates heavier freight trains and larger passenger trains. It also increases line capacity due to increased average speeds, better starting and braking parameters, and capability to run larger and heavier trains. It affords more reliable power supply to the signaling systems and necessarily replaces semaphore signaling with multi-aspect color light signaling. Electric traction is eco-friendly and energy-efficient mode of transport. And of course, it enables faster and cleaner suburban intercity services.
So you just mentioned that running passenger and goods train on electric traction is cheaper than diesel traction. Can you provide the comparison, please?
According to the latest data available, the line haul cost on electric traction is about 43% cheaper than diesel traction. At present, there are only two modes of traction available, that is the diesel traction and the electric traction. The line haul cost in rupees per 1000 GTKMs or gross ton kilometers for coaching traffic on electric traction is about 118 rupees cheaper as compared to diesel traction. And similarly, for goods traffic, the line haul cost on electric traction is about 77 rupees cheaper as compared to diesel traction. Thus, the savings, if the entire passenger traffic presently on diesel traction is taken on electric traction, would be about rupees 3840 crores, and the corresponding amount for goods traffic would be rupees 2440 crores per year. Thus, the overall savings would be very sizable, rupees 6280 crores per year, if all the diesel traffic is taken on electric traction.
What are the factors which decide electrification of a particular route to be electrified or not on Indian railways?
Electrification of railway routes is primarily based on economic considerations. In addition to economic considerations, the operational necessity and availability of resources also plays a great part in deciding the electrification of a route. The criteria and the guidelines being followed are: number one, the rate of return in an electrification project should be 14% or more. only then the project is considered as economically justifiable. Secondly, in specific cases, the electrification is also considered on the grounds of operational flexibility, that is, provision of seamless traffic operations and minimizing detentions. And lastly, the other short sections, which would otherwise remain isolated in electrified segments, are also taken up for electrification to ease operations.
So you just mentioned that electrification projects are taken up when the rate of return is 14% or more. Whether Indian Railways actually finds out the rate of return once the project is completed or not?
Yes, railways do carry out sensitivity analysis of electrification projects to confirm the rate of return. And we have found in almost every case, the actual rate of return exceeds 14%. We have seen that in many cases, it is as high as 30%, which means that in a little more than 3 years' time, we can get back entire investment on electrification project.
What are the major achievements of the Corps in last few years?
During the last year, we have achieved highest electrification of 937 route kilometers, surpassing the previous best of 916 route kilometers achieved during 2009-10. In addition, CRS inspection of 1159 route kilometers has been conducted, which is the highest achievement in the history of Corps. And we surpassed the previous best of 992 kilometers achieved during 1991, that is almost 23 years back. The strategies adopted in last few years have started paying rich dividends. In last few years, despite acute shortage of manpower and resources and several other constraints, the route kilometers energized have increased exponentially from 170 route kilometers in 2005-06 to 937 route kilometers in 2012-13. It would not be out of place to mention that the manpower productivity has taken a quantum jump. It has gone up from 10 route kilometers per 100 men in mid-90s to 40 route kilometers per 100 men in 2012-13, and it is the highest productivity achieved so far.
What strategies were adopted by Corps to increase the pace of railway electrification?
Faced with the daunting task of increasing the pace of electrification with the reduced manpower and limited suppliers, we made effort to bring together all the stakeholders in the journey of progress. Firstly, repeated interactions were held with the suppliers to instill confidence in them regarding the future growth of electrification. With this strategy, all the suppliers were motivated to allocate more resources and also to augment their existing capacities to produce the required material for railway electrification work. Apart from the already approved sources, interactions were also held with the various manufacturers engaged in the business of similar type of activities, with a view to bring them to produce items required for railway electrification. The vendor approval system was also streamlined to cut out the procedural delays and to develop an atmosphere of mutual trust and between Corps and the various manufacturers. For works contracts, earlier Corps was placing mostly labor intensive contracts, where major items like different type of steel and copper required for RE work was used to be supplied by railways to the contractors. It is, of course, very difficult to ensure matching the supply of material with the requirement at site perfectly. In addition to this, Core was also placing separate contracts for different component of works. However, such an arrangement invariably results in mismatching of completion of various component of works. In order to overcome this, Core has tried composite turnkey contracts where different type of materials were placed under the scope of work. By making composite contracts, all the components of work do get completed simultaneously, dovetailing with the completion of the project. This has resulted into faster execution of works.
What is the share of electrification on Indian Railways?
As in March 2013, that is the last year, 36.44% of route kilometers of Indian Railways had been electrified. But we carried more than 65% of the freight traffic and more than 50% of passenger traffic on electric traction. In order to move this traffic, the share of electric traction in overall fuel cost is only 38%. This is a clear indication of low cost incurred by railways in adopting electric traction.
Which are the major sections which have been recently converted to electrified territory by Core?
Core has recently completed electrification of Moradabad Mughalsarai section via Uttaretia. With the completion of this section, the entire route from Amritsar to Mughalsarai has been put on electric traction. It will provide seamless operation of electric traction services from Amritsar to Howrah, and it will result in considerable saving of time in addition to the savings of precious imported diesel fuel. Apart from being environmental friendly, this also decongests heavily saturated A route from New Delhi to Mughalsarai via Kanpur and Allahabad, providing an alternative route. After commissioning of Pathankot Jammu Tawi section on electric traction in current year, Jammu Tawi will also be connected to seamless electric traction with major metro cities of India. The work of providing the electrified railway route on Jammu Tawi, Udhampur, Srinagar, Paramura section will also be synchronized with ongoing new line works in the same section. In addition, the electrification of small sections of Shakur Basti Rohtak, Ujjain Indore, and Trivandrum Kanyakumari have also been recently completed, giving immense benefits. This is because these sections were unelectrified small patches lying adjacent to electrified sections.
Which sections are currently being electrified by Core and what are its future plans?
Planning Commission wants earlier electrification and faster electrification. In Vision 2020 document issued by Ministry of Railways in December 2009, electrification of 14,000 route kilometers has been envisaged in a period of 10 years, that is during 2011 to 2020. Out of this, a total of 3,457 route kilometers have been electrified during first 3 years. In the remaining period, that is 2013-14 to 2019-20, a total of 10,543 route kilometers are to be electrified. At present, a total of 8,113 route kilometers of sanctioned works are in hand, out of which physical works have been completed in 2,849 route kilometers by March 2013. there are more than 30 projects where CORE is presently carrying out the electrification work, which is being managed by 10 field units all over the country. As announced in budget of 2013-14, work will also be started in the section Delhi Sarai Rohilla to Ahmedabad, including Kalol, Khodiyar and Alwar Phulera, and also Singapore Road to Daman Jodi section will also commence. In the times to come, the railway also plans to electrify various non-electrified routes, including missing electrification links and feeder routes to dedicated freight corridor, etc. Techno-economical feasibility survey for electrification of many sections is being carried out.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your such an informative talk. I wish all the best to CORE for future electrification. Thank you once again for your time, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much for showing interest in railway electrification.
Recent RE projects on the go. Ambala Project. RE Ambala Project was set up in September 1991 for electrification of Delhi-Ambala section. Over the years, the project has commissioned electrification of Ambala-Ludhiana, Jalandhar-Amritsar, Ambala-Saharanpur, Ambala-Saharanpur-Muradabad, Ambala-Chandigarh-Kalka and Sarhind, Nangal Dam, Una. Shakur Basti, Rohtak and Muradabad, Rosa section successfully. The work is in progress in groups which are 107, Khurja Meerut City, Saharanpur and Ghaziabad Meerut City, 143, Jalandhar Jammu Tawi Udhampur, 159, Ghaziabad Muradabad, 160, Rohtak Bathinda Lehra Mohabbat, 182, Delhi Sarai Rohila Rewari, 179, Udhampur Katra and 180, Katra Dharam sections over Northern Railway and spread over Uttar Pradesh, Haryana, Delhi, Punjab and Jammu and Kashmir. Bhuvaneshwar Project. Bhuvaneshwar unit was set up during August 1995 for execution of electrification work of Khadakpur Bhuvaneshwar project known as KBRE project. Over the years, the project has completed the electrification works in Adra Midnapur, Khadakpur Bhuvaneshwar, including sidings, Bhuvaneshwar Kota Valasa, Krishnanagar Lal Gola over Southeastern Railway, East Coast Railway, and Eastern Railway. The work is in progress, which is 162 Khana Sainthia Pakur, Panda Beswar Sainthia, 166 Vizianagaram Singapore Road, 167 Singapore Road Titalagarh, 168 Andal Sitarampur via Jamuria Ikhra, 170 Jharsuguda Titalagarh, 172 Pakur Malda Town, 181 Singapore Road Daman Jodi sections over Eastern Railway and East Coast Railway and spread over Andhra Pradesh, Odisha, West Bengal and Jharkhand. Chennai Project. RE Chennai Project was set up in November 1973 in the presence of Shri M. Karunanidhi, Honorable Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, for electrification of Madras Guddur section. This project has completed 40 years of continuous service. At present, Chennai Project is handling 6 groups, which are 126 Bangalore Suburban Area, 154 Madurai Tuticorin Nagarkoil section, 155 Villupuram Villore Cant section, 157 and 158 Shoranur Mangalore Penambur section, 169 Coimbatore Mettapalayam section. The works are progressing in all the above sections, which are spread over Tamil Nadu, Kerala, covering Southern Railway. Jaipur Project. The project was formed in May 2013 for electrification of Delhi Rewari Palanpur Phulera Ahmedabad section. This project is also looking after the residual or balance work of Kota project, that is 148 Jhansi-Kanpur, including Kanpur-Anwarganj-Kalyanpur section, 138 Indore-Ujjain-Devas-Maksi section, 163-165 Mathura-Alwar and Alwar-Rewari section. The jurisdiction of Jaipur project is spread over North Central Railway, North Western Railway and Western Railways, covering four states, which are Uttar Pradesh, Haryana, Rajasthan and Gujarat. Lucknow project. Lucknow project formation was done in October 1998 after sanction of Lucknow-Kanpur section. This project has so far electrified 805 railway kilometers. The work executed by this project so far is Lucknow-Kanpur 113, Lucknow Circular Area 122, Rosa-Uttaratia 125, Uttaratia-Sultanpur 136 and Sultanpur-Mughalsarai 137. Further work is under progress in Varanasi-Papamau, Allahabad-Unchahar 153 and Rosa-Sitapur-Barwal 164. Work is spread over Northern Railway and Northeast Railway, falling in Uttar Pradesh. The notable achievement of this project was completion of Lucknow Circular Project around Lucknow within 8 months, and the same was inaugurated by the Honorable Prime Minister on the 26th of June 2002 by introducing MEMU services in Lucknow. Sikandrabad Project. RE Sikandrabad unit was formed in June 2007. At present, this project is handling work of 5 groups, 132 and 132A Lingampally to Wadi, 156 Kengeri, Mysore, 161 Gondia, Ballar Shah, 177 and 178 Nalla Paddu, Guntakal, covering 3 states, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka and Maharashtra, and spreading over South Central Railway, Southern Western Railway and Southeast Central Railway. New Jalpaiguri Project. New Jalpaiguri unit was set up during February 2009 for electrification of Katihar-Guwahati section spread over Northeast Frontier Railway and Bihar, West Bengal and Assam states. The project is at present handling work of Katihar-Barsoi via Kumedpur-Raninagar-Jalpaiguri. 151 Raninagar-Jalpaiguri, New Bongaigaon, 152 Bongaigaon, Guwahati and 171 Kumedpur-Malda Town, including Old Malda Town, Singhabad sections of North Frontier Railway and Eastern Railway. Gorakhpur Project. Gorakhpur Project was formed out of Lucknow Unit in 2007. The jurisdiction of Gorakhpur project is from Barabanki-Chhapra-Kachhehari, spread over Northeastern Railway. The project is handling work of 2 groups, namely GR-141, Gorakhpur-Kant-Chhapra, including Sivan-Thave section, and GR-142, Gorakhpur-Barabanki, spread over Bihar and Uttar Pradesh. Danapur project. Danapur unit was set up in May 2013 for electrification of Garhwa Road, Chopan Singrauli section. The project is also handling balance work of Hajipur project comprising of 3 groups, 140A Hajipur Baroni via Muzaffarpur, 140B Chhapra Kacheri Bachhawada via Shahpur Patori and Sonpur Patna junction, New Ganga Bridge, and 149 Baroni Katihar section spread over Eastern Central Railway, falling in Bihar. Jabalpur project. RE Jabalpur unit was set up in December 2012 for electrification of Allahabad-Itarsi, including Satna-Rewa section spread over North Central Railway and West Central Railway, falling in Uttar Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh. Central Organization for Railway Electrification, or CORE. With its headquarters at Allahabad, it is effectively monitoring and executing its projects, assisted by its 10 project offices, having successfully completed electrification of more than 23,000 RKM with prestigious landmarks of achievements to its credit spread across the length and breadth of India. Railway electrification today is proud of its glorious past and looks forward to an even more glorious future. As of today, nearly 65.6% of freight and 50.4% of passenger traffic is hauled on electric traction on 23,541 RKM. In electric traction, the electric locomotive takes power through pantograph from UHE or overhead equipment laid along track. Power supply is taken at HT voltages of 66/110/132/220 kV from state electricity boards through transmission lines up to railway-owned traction substations and stepped down to 25 kV for supply to OHE. The actual work of laying OHE on the track is undertaken by CORE through contracts. The materials are supplied to various reputed contractors for doing the erection and later energizing the entire section. Most of the works, such as erection of masts, portals, as well as drawing of contact and catenary wires, are done under traffic blocks. If regular blocks are made available and the requisite powers in the form of steam or diesel shunter are made available, the entire work in a section of about 200 kilometers could be covered in just 2 years. Where the traffic blocks are not available, certain experiments have been conducted by the use of helicopters, particularly in Nagpur-Wardha section in the year 1990-91. The mast erection was found to be comparatively very fast and the work could be done during the whole day without any traffic blockage. Multi-aspect color light signaling or MACLS is being provided as a standard at all stations and level crossing gates along with introduction of 25 kV AC, thereby enhancing visibility of signals, boosting the confidence of drivers besides safety in train operation. With the electrification, overhead telecom wires are replaced to avoid induction effect on telecom circuits by underground OFC cables along with the provision of emergency communication sockets along with the railway track. Centralized Network Management System or NMS is being provided as an integral part of the OFC system for online monitoring and maintenance of entire OFC network commissioned over the section of railway to ensure reliability and availability of quality voice and data channel, thus empowering Indian Railways to cater for speedier, cost-effective and safe train operations. To enable suitable central control and have all the data regarding the position of power supply all along the route at any instance, Supervisory Remote Control System, that is SCADA, has been provided to make the actual condition at site to the power controller. This enables stripping of power in case of emergency and making power blocks available for the OHE maintenance. Railway electrification has consistently upgraded itself to meet technological challenges and carried out innovations and modernization to achieve and accomplish state-of-the-art 25,000 volt OHE supply network. Some of them are: firstly, increased electrification and productivity. The above strategy or methodology implemented with effect from financial year 2006-2007 onwards resulted in achievement of encouraging results right from the first year itself. Such a continuous rising trend in output as well as productivity of the order of more than 50% enhancement per year is usually not observed even in most efficient private sector organizations. Secondly, commissioning of 2x25 kV system in Bina Katni sector in the year 1994-95, offering the advantage of longer spacing between substation heavy haulage. This system is being adopted for the eastern and western freight corridors. Third, commissioning of world's highest OHE in 2008-2009. CORE was asked to erect an OHE at 7.45 meters height in Jakhapura Daitri section of East Coast Railway for conducting double stack container trials so that decision on electrification of Western Corridor of Dedicated Freight Corridor Corporation of India Limited could be taken. CORE took up the challenge and erected high-rise OHE on a stretch of 24 route kilometers and energized the same with 25 kV in a record time under adverse weather conditions. The successful double-stack container trials on electric traction on this stretch enabled resultant clearance by the Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs for electric traction on Western Corridor also, which would certainly go a long way in achieving the objective of fast economical transportation of the export traffic on Western Corridor. Central Organization for Railway Electrification is having close liaison with Research, Design and Standards Organization Lucknow regarding latest technologies and improvements in various equipments and materials adopted in railway electrification to bring in the state-of-the-art technology. The maintenance problems being faced by zonal railways are being considered while designs are made, as well as to keep the cost of electrification works in an optimum manner. CORE continues to work with zeal and enthusiasm with committed team of officers, supervisors and staff to work in close coordination with zonal railways to complete the works in targeted time so as to achieve the corporate objectives of Indian Railways.